It's a genetic muscle, you can train it, and it won't work, and that's bullshit. So here we are at World's Gym, about to hit a chest and calf workout. This is episode 2 to the series of the Road to the Natty Mr. Australia. I am 8 and 10 weeks out from my ICN Mr. Australia contest and INBA Mr. Australia contest. Today we're getting after some chest and calves. So as far as the workout goes, I'll get my usual 10 minutes of warm-up in. I'll do a little bit of extra shoulder mobility work today and pre-warm-up stuff because I've got a bit of an issue in here. I'm treating it with CBD oil at the moment and ice packs after my workouts. It's just a niggling injury. As you get leaner in a contest prep, you get less fat around your joints, which puts the joint at greater risk of inflammation and injury. And I'm dealing with a bit of bicep tendon inflammation here. So, you know, bench press is going to expose that today. I've rubbed a fair bit of CBD oil on it, which is awesome at getting rid of inflammation, but I'll basically do a little bit more warm-up stuff, some lighter sets. I'll move into some flat bench. I'll do 2 or 3 working sets at around 6 to 8 reps with the main focus on my muscle connection. With chest especially, you'll notice with natural competitors, their chest seems to fizzle out and end up paper thin. I've always kept a really thick chest throughout the off-season and contest prep because I'm obsessive with my muscle connection and stimulating the muscle fibers to grow or to maintain. So I'll keep the weight nice and heavy on basic flat bench. From there, we'll move over to an incline movement. It may be hammer strength, it may be Smith machine. I'll feel it, I'll see what machine is free. From there, I'll probably do a dumbbell press or something where I can kind of come in with internal rotation, and then I'll finish the chest movement with some flies. I'll show you guys a couple of different intensity techniques along the way, and then from there, we'll move into calves. Calves will be simple. We'll be doing something with a locked knee to work the gastroc. Okay, and then we'll be doing a set of calf raises. I'll be doing 3 working sets on both, maximal intensity, as heavy weight as I can handle under my muscle connection, and we'll be done. So let's get into it. Old headphones on. So basically, since day one, man, I've always done a warm-up. Like, I've tested warming up versus not warming up. And the performance difference when you've got, you know, 5-10 minutes of easy cardio and your heart rate's kind of 140, blood flowing, versus going into the gym and pumping weights cold, is like chalk and cheese. So even on the days that I cannot be bothered doing it, I'll make sure that I do it. Because your performance suffers if you don't. Just to warm up the rear delts and the traps and rhomboids. Tapping the microphone, aren't I? It's fine warming up these muscles, just helps keep that shoulder blade retraction and depression throughout the bench movement, which is crucial to get that mind-muscle connection through the pec. All right, so working set 1, we're gonna start super light. And the goal is just to maximize my muscle connection and get the right movement pattern. So I'll start with something very far away from my working set, with the goal of gradually priming the muscle, nervous system, mindset, to be able to handle max weight for my working sets. I never normally count reps. Probably end up being somewhere between 15 and 20. You notice I'm stopping very far away from lockout because I'm trying to keep tension on the chest. Once the chest is fully contracted, there's no point in looking at the elbow any further. Warm up 1 done. All right, so this is the 3rd warm up set. 80 kilos, including the bar. Basically, my whole goal with the warm-up is to slowly warm up the pecs, the mindset, and the nervous system to be able to handle those 2 heavy working sets. So if I walked into the gym and didn't warm up, like most blokes, these guys, straight into my heavy sets, I wouldn't be able to move much weight. I wouldn't be effective, I wouldn't be stimulating muscle fibers in the chest, and I'd be like everybody else, especially every natty with no chest. All right, this warm-up process enables you to actually build a chest and work up to 2 heavy sets that's gonna stress the muscles enough to
to adapt and respond, which is to get bigger. So this is warm-up set 3. I'll do 4, 5, 6, whatever warm-up sets it takes me until I can reach my heavy working sets. So I've worked up to a heavy weight today, our working set. This is 120, off season with a bit more fat around the joint. I'll normally press 3 plates, 140. Today we're going for 6 to 10 reps, good quality. So we finished our 2 working sets on flat bench. Now I'm going to hit the incline. Decided I'm going to give Smith Machine a go today. I'll rotate between, you know, barbell, incline, hammer strength incline, dumbbell incline, and Smith Machine incline. They all have their benefits. I'm using Smith Machine today because the shoulders are a bit inflamed, so I'm not having to stabilize the weight. We'll give the shoulder joint a bit of a break. All right, I'll do one warm-up set just to acclimate the movement, and then I'll do 2 heavy workings. All right, so we're finished up on the incline. We're coming over for some pec flies now. I prefer machine to dumbbells at this point in prep because it eases off the joint. We're doing some moderate to heavy weight today with a little intensity technique that you'll see in a moment. So I pause at the start with the contraction, hold for 3, and then I'll do 8 reps, 10 reps, and then I'll pause at the end for 3 as well. So it's just a way of overloading the muscle without overloading the joint. You know, in the off season, I'll do the whole stack plus weight to try and fail at that 6 to 10. Now that I'm a bit leaner and the joint's a bit sore, I'm looking at other ways to add intensity and overload whilst keeping the mind-muscle connection still there. We'll be right back. All right, so moving on to calves now. First exercise I'm gonna do with a straight leg, so locked knees. Works more the gastrocnemius, which is the upper part of the calf. I'm gonna do it on the pin loaded. I'll do 3 or 4 warm-up sets and then 3 heavy working sets at around that 8 to 12 rep mark. All right, second warm-up set. We're gradually working towards our working weights. Alrighty, so we're queued up for the first working set. Now, there's no escaping the fact that my calves are my weakest muscle group. I justified probably for the first 10 years of my lifting career that their genetics, you know, I don't have calf genetics. It's a genetic muscle, you can train it and it won't work, and that's bullshit. Because in the last year I've dedicated to training them a lot more often and there's definitely gains, you know. Calf genetics are one thing as far as insertion, how high up it will insert, but you can always maximize your genetics. So don't be like me in that aspect and train calves with the same amount of effort, priority and intensity as you do everywhere else, otherwise you'll look like me, which is very out of symmetric, which is very unsymmetrical from my calf to my arm. All right, heavy working set 1, 8 to 12 is the goal. Alright, so we finished up on the straight leg. Now we're moving over to the bent leg. I'm going to do 1 acclimation set, which is like a warm-up. Just priming the calf to the nervous system for the 3 heavy working sets. So I like to start this with a peak contraction. I'll hold just to trigger, get a full stretch, grab it up. All right, so working set 1. All right, so working set 1 of 3. I'm gonna start with a 3-second contraction at the top to fire the calf before getting as many reps as I can. Full contractions. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. All right, so that's it. Chest and calves are done. Solid workout. Fair bit of niggles through my shoulder. I've got an appointment with my remedial masseur, Addy, who's actually a world-class weightlifter and crossfitter tomorrow. So hopefully that can help. It's a good session, good my muscle connection, fair bit of information, but we got through it. Currently my macros are 255 protein, 175 carbs on my 6 low days, 295 carbs on my 1 high day, and 52 grams of fat. I think it works out being about 2,300 calories. That's 8 and 10 weeks out. 8 and 10 weeks out. Definitely on track for conditioning. Posing needs a bit of work, but all in all, mindset's good. Feeling excited. Stress is manageable, and strength is really good in the gym. So until next time, stay natty.